Our topic for the presentation is quality of service. Quality of service is the description, or it is an overall measurement of the performance of a service, such as a telephony or a computer network or any cloud computing service. The primary goal of quality of service is to provide priority, including dedicated bandwidth, control jitter and latency, and improve loss characteristics. Providing priority for one or more flows does not affect other flows. Flow characteristics. Here we have four types of flow characteristics. First one is reliability, second is delay, fourth is jitter, fifth is bandwidth. Reliability. Lack of reliability means losing a packet or an acknowledgement, which entails retransmission. Delay. Applications can tolerate delay in different degrees. In case of telephony and audio conferencing, login need minimum delay, while delaying file transfer or email is less important. Jitter. Jitter is the variation in delay for packets belonging to the same flow. If the packets depart at times 0, 1, 2, 3 and arrive at 21, 22, 23, all have the same delay, 20 units of time. On the other hand, if the packets arrival time is different and they have different delays, then there will be a difference in the delay. Bandwidth. Different applications would have different bandwidths. There are few techniques to improve quality of service. Four techniques we have here: scheduling, which is FIFO queuing, priority queuing and weighted fare queuing. Second is traffic shaping, leaky bucket, token bucket, admission control and resource reservation. Scheduling. Packets from different flows arrive at a switch or a router at first for the processment. A good scheduling technique treats the different flows in a fair and appropriate manner. We have the three scheduling techniques. FIFO queuing. In this technique, packets wait in a buffer until the node is ready to process. Priority queuing. Here, packets are first assigned to a priority class. Each priority class has its own queue. The packets of the highest priority are processed first. Weighted fare queuing. In this queuing, the queues are weighted based on the priority of the queues. Higher priority means a higher weight, lower priority means a lower weight. So the queues having higher weight are processed first. Traffic shaping. Traffic shaping controls the rate at which packets are sent. These are basically used in ATM and integrated service network. At connection setup time, the sender and carrier negotiate a traffic pattern. We have two traffic shaping algorithms here, leaky bucket and token bucket. Leaky bucket algorithm can be seen over here. The leaky bucket algorithm is used to control the rate in a network. It is implemented as a single server queue with constant service time. If the bucket overflows, then the packets are discarded. Leaky bucket, for every hour time units, sends a packet. For an arriving packet, if queue not full, then queue. Note that output is a perfect constant rate. Here we can see the image of a leaky bucket with water, a leaky bucket with packets. Second, we have the token bucket algorithm. The bucket holds tokens. To transmit a packet, we use one token. It depends on the size of the burst in contrast to the leaky bucket. So here we can see the diagram for token bucket before and after. Admission control. Admission control refers to the mechanism used by a router or a switch to accept or reject a flow based on predefined parameters called flow specifications. Before a router accepts a flow for processing, it checks the flow specifications to see if its capacity and its previous commitments to other flows can handle the new flow. Second, we have the resource reservation. A flow of data needs resources such as buffer, CPU time, bandwidth and many. The QoS is improved if these resources are reserved beforehand. Here we have the 10 questions related to quality of service which should be answered. Thank you.